Good morning, welcome to another walk. Today we are heading to Turf Moor, so we're in Burnley. We're currently on the Sandholm Aqueduct, so this is the Leeds and Liverpool Canal here. Down here is the River Brun. And we're going to be heading off in this direction to go find Turf Moor, nip into the shop there and then have a walk through the town centre, so come join us. Now, this might give us the distances to both the names of the canal. So Leeds is 53.25 miles in this direction, and the other side, I was hoping the other side would say distance to Liverpool. Maybe that's not what the canal does. I thought there were two mallards, there's actually four, there's two pairs, but somehow the ladies in just the brown disappear into the green quite well. And yes, as Kerry just said before I was filming, this does look like you could walk on it, but don't. It's just a layer of tiny little weed leaves on the surface. You would still end up in the water. The cans floating on top of it don't help with the illusion either. Definitely not grass. The grass is on that side. A small respite from the weed. What this probably means is that something is draining into the canal here, possibly. It could be many things. It could be something's draining into the canal here and pushing all the weed over to the far side. It could just be the way the wind is here, pushes the weed out the way. It could be, I don't know, it's any number of things, because it then covers the canal again just up here.
Got a bird watching.
Now this one has nothing on this side, so does this have a distance on the other side? Nope. This one has a distance on no side, it's lost its plaque altogether. Ah, now. It's a nice northern terraced street. Yeah, I see this on, what is it? It shows like, it was 2 pints longer. You've got the back alleys where all the yards, yard gates are. And then you've got the front roads and the terraces. I was going to say I can't see much of a stadium, but I can see some lights up here. So I'm going to assume it's just there. So I think we cross this bridge up here and then come down off the canal and go find the stadium. Although I only see two sets of lights, not four. Oh, that's where we won the long entrance of the pitch there, so the pitch will be that direction. It's a little drizzly today, or of course, as they say, nice weather for ducks. And they do seem to be enjoying it. Hello. Got an interesting coloration. Unfortunately, that's probably why he's on his own. Wild is the nature is cruel. There's another one over there with the white front. And a natural wild flip-flop. Or thong if you're Australian. It means something very different than British. Nice bit of canal heritage here, an old crane. I'm not quite sure what that would be used. Obviously, we're just getting stuff off boats. Not quite sure where to, whether there would have been a yard over there or whether it would have been able to load stuff down onto vehicles on the road below here. So we'll be coming back round and under this bridge in a minute. And then heading up to the stadium, which is just up there. And someone's been letting off fireworks. Assuming that's meant to have... Oh, it is carvings of some sort. It's just really difficult to see what they are. But we're going down here. And welcome to Burnley bus station. It looks like there should be some steps down here, but there's not. Just some benches. Well, that's where we just were. Canal in what looks like a metal trough. Let me guess what colours the team playing. Is it claret and blue?
Yeah.
Same as?
West Ham and Aston Villa.
How do they get away with that? Just where they have to wear the away kits when they play each other?
Yeah.
Fair enough. Yeah, how do we get through here?
It's the same as Arsenal, Man United and Liverpool.
That's true.
They're all red.
I think that's the cricket club. We'll come back around to that later. Just the other side of the car park there. I like that they've got on this lampposts here, they've got illuminated sign holders, where presumably there will be, when it comes to match day, some club signs up and they're illuminated. Visiting supporters entrance. I do like when they've actually got local sponsors on stadiums, not massive airlines, although I see why that happens. I see Burnley Football Club up there, but can't read it from this side of the road. There's that Premier League money with the LED screens on reception. Reception, ticket office, and then the shop down there. So that's where we're going next. So again, we are looking for the cheapest thing they have. Task set by our nephews. Instead of going through there, I think we're actually going to sneak down the back here into the park. We'll go up there in a sec, but this looks kind of fun. It's a Burnley memorial. One of the supporters of Burnley Football Club who gave their lives in sacrifice during the Great War. Let's take a gamble here on whether to go through the ground, and I wasn't entirely sure we could get out the far side. It looks like you've got a fan zone inside the grounds there, which is kind of fun. Is that cheaper tickets, slightly cheaper tickets, do you reckon? To go and watch the game in the fan zone. But we're now just gonna go around the outside wall. Across some lovely little bungalows. This would be amazing as a kid, you've got so much space to play between all the grass between the bungalows, it's nice. Ooh, that's a bright house. Wake you up in the morning. I think this is the cricket club. Hopefully we'll find a sign for it when we get up to the road. I can confirm that. Ah, okay. This is access to the football ground. So that's where we couldn't make the loop round. That's access to this home stand at the end here. And this is Burnley Cricket Club. Right next door. And you see the word turf on the chairs up there. The rain's just got a bit heavier, so we're now sheltering under a tree. We're going to wait here for a couple of minutes, hope it eases off, and then we'll carry on. Back of the roadworks, so we're going to go back down here, back down under the canal bridge, and then carry on from there. On the side of the turf pub. And there's another one over here. If we want to film that. It's the one on the other side. Trimming the bushes a little bit there. That's definitely the Sainsbury's influence there, someone shopping. Hafner's doesn't even have to tell you what it is. If you're local, you probably just know. I think it's a butcher's. This is nice. I wonder if this is what they're doing up there. They're making it all to match in with the nice block paving here. Oh, poor Wilco. Starting to rain again. Well, just starting to rain heavier again. Charles Walk Shopping Centre, but if you've seen my previous videos, you know I'm not allowed to film in places like that without permission, because reasons. So I think we'll just hide under this roof here. Who's the river? Just about at capacity and just about to flood over the edge here. I just slightly confused myself there, because I had in mind that we were heading down to the river, but I think we're heading up to the canal. This has all got a bit fancy up here. And back to the canal. Okay, I was going to find somewhere for us to sit and look at what we got from the Burnley FC shop, but everywhere around here is wet, so we'll stand up and do this. What was the cheap thing we managed to get from the Burnley shop?
Postcards.
Postcards. Priced up at £1, but she couldn't find them on the till, so she gave them for free, so I don't think that one's going to be beatable.
No.
Unless we can actually find something free from another shop.
Yep.
So £1/free, depending on how you want to do it. So that's where we're going to end for today. Thank you very much for joining us. I hope you enjoyed that one. If you did, like, subscribe, all that. And there'll be another video next week, the week after, the week after. So thank you very much for joining us. Have a lovely afternoon.